Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening. It's so good to be here. And welcome to TheatreWorks' 40th anniversary concert. I'm Tony Haney. One time associate artistic director, ongoing director, actor, and friend to the company, to the family. So turn off your cell phones, notice the exits, and fasten your seatbelts. Our journey tonight is filled with innovation and inspiration, music and memories, new works, and old friends. And here's an old friend, a friend for life, star of both Crowns and It Ain't Nothing But the Blues, the immortal Michael Jordan.
Raise your foot now, that's the way you'll be moving on today. Raise the other, put it down. Now you're headed into town. Whoa, boy, you got left, right. Whoa, boy, ain't that right?
Great composers light our path tonight, beginning with this luminous song from Jeanine Tesoro's Violet. Brian Crowley's lyrics capture TheatreWorks' journey in a single phrase. Let it sing.
Got some years ahead to go. You'll go free if you take it slow. Whoa, boy, you got left, right. Oh, boy, ain't that right?
TheatreWorks' journey belongs to all of us, audience and artists alike. But tonight we celebrate someone who's shaped that journey for 40 years. From its first flight in 1970 to its remarkable fame today, artistic director and friend, Robert Kelly.
Start not always as expected. Say no, you stay apart, but you stay protected. You've got to give yourself a reason to rejoice. Let the music you make count for everything. Now every living soul has got a voice. You've got to give it room and let it sing. My family never had too much, made the best of every day. Ate what's on their plates, you know, never threw a thing away. We placed our nightmares on the shelf, our dreams were on the table. Pass them down and help yourself as long as you are able. My mama told me, honey, forget what might have been. Give yourself a break, whatever's happening. Don't let your spirit, hun, come closing in. You've got to give it room and let it sing. You've got to give it room and let it sing. You've got to lift up your voice and sing it. Got some years ahead to go. Go free if you take it slow. Got some years and it won't be long. You'll be free to sing your song. Whoa, boy, you got left, right, precious little really folks like us control. Make your music count. We're from the simplest thing. Now you're the one has got to turn your soul. You've got to give it room and let it sing. You've got to give it room.
In your seatbelts. Wow. You know, I've done about a dozen shows with Michelle, and wow. Now, Theater Works' journey has indeed been full of song, but it has also overflowed with brilliant drama. We are honored to have with us tonight one of America's greatest dramatists, author of Tony Award-winning M. Butterfly and Obie Award-winning Yellowface, a two-time finalist for the Pulitzer Prize and writer of the Broadway musicals Tarzan, Aida, and the revival of Flower Drum Song. I gotta slow down. David is an artist we are all proud, very proud to call a friend. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our guest MC, David Henry Wong.
Thank you. Thank you, Puccini. And thank you for the chance to be part of this tremendous celebration. And thank you, Theater Works, for your exceptional productions of my plays, and they have demonstrated Theater Works' commitment to explore the diversity of this amazing Silicon Valley. And check out this outstanding set for To Kill a Mockingbird. That's Boo Radley's house right there, very scary. But tonight's journey does not focus on individual productions. It celebrates a collective process. It's not about points in time, but about a point of view, not about the past, but about the passion that has burned brightly for four decades and promises a dynamic future. Tonight, we celebrate 40 years of innovation in the technology of Silicon Valley and the art of Theater Works. We honor the work of seven exceptional composers whose premieres have graced this stage. As their music sings, we celebrate their roots in Theater Works' vast artistic family. It is impossible not to sense that family in this room tonight, linking us all in this very special anniversary. Two remarkable composer lyricists have found a home here in the New Works Festival and on the main stage. Founders of the band Groove Lily, composers of Disney's Toy Story the Musical, and authors of Theater Works' world premiere hits, Striking 12, and Long Story Short, here are the immensely talented Brendan Milburn and Valerie Vigoda.
Hi, everybody. I'm so bummed out I can't be there in person with you guys to celebrate, but really excited that I can at least join you this way from my basement studio and join my bandmates in thanking you guys, everybody at Theater Works and Kelly and Ev and the whole team. It's just been such a great ride, and you guys have been such a tremendous part of our development as a band. And And just personally, I love everyone there, and I can't wait to come back in December for Striking 12, and I can't wait to play a song for you right now. So have fun.
That's Gene. He's our drummer.
One, two, three, four.
We asked Ev Shiro, what song should we play? What is Kelly like? She said, you should play No Room in Your Bag because it's on Kelly's Desert Island list. Consequently, this is No Room in Your Bag. She said in 1967 she got married to my father with a borrowed pair of blue jeans and a bridesmaid. And San Francisco was a bubble of excitement like a butterfly flapping in the stomach of a decade. She didn't know exactly everything he'd been through. She didn't know exactly what she'd gotten into. She got an offer from a magazine to write about the music scene because they liked her resume and bio. She told her husband who'd been offered a position in the faculty of music at a college in Ohio. Said you either take the job or save our marriage. Well, she put her luggage in the back of his carriage. And she said, you make a choice, you make a call. You may rise, you may fall, and you will pay for what you get. You got no room in your bag for regrets. She said that 1975 was like a purgatory doing needlepoint inside a decompression chamber. Cincinnati was a garden of conservatism growing like a vine that tried to tie her down and tame her. She said, now surely there has been a big mistake here. This ain't resembling the mark I want to make here. She saw her future like a single at the bottom of a stack of records that'll never ever see the buzz bin. And she had subjugated all of her desires for the good of the family unit to the betterment of the husband. She saw that they had not been marching to the same drum. Well, she took her son and hit the road to where she came from. And she said, you make a choice, you make a call. You may rise, you may fall, and you will pay for what you get. You got no room in your bag for regret. She drove that peanut pinto out to California. She kept the windows down and the air was hot and dry. She kept hearing Joe Cocker on the radio singing, you are so beautiful, and it always made her cry. And in the rearview mirror, piled high of a crib and walker, toys and clothes and little shoes for little tiny feet. There ain't no room in here for things she wished she might have done. Only her behind the wheel. Consequence of all her actions, fast asleep on the passenger seat. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
This is the part where you sing along.
Yeah, yeah.
Try this too. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah. Let's all pretend that we are all big Bon Jovi fans. And this is a Bon Jovi concert in Madison Square Garden on New Year's Eve. And let's all pretend that you know this song. Even better than that, let's pretend that it's May 8th, and we are in Mountain View celebrating Robert Kelly and 40 years of theater work. Yeah! She said that 1989 was like a fuse that burned an excerpt lit to the dynamite of my departure. And she was sad that I was growing up, but glad to shoot me out into the world like an arrow from an archer. As I was packing up to leave and go to college, well, she took a minute to impart a bit of knowledge. And she said, you make a choice, you make a call. You may rise, you may fall. And you will pay, you will pay for what you get. But you got no room in your bag for regret. You make a choice, you make a call. No room in your bag for regret. Well, you got no room in your bag for regret. Let's do it again.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. cheap seats, please. Yeah, yeah, yeah. 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 Two fingers.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That sounds good, but I need more from over here, please.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Thank you very much. Good night. We are Bon Jovi.
Thank you, Gene.
Gene is in New Jersey this evening, but he still plays the drums very well.
One of the hallmarks of a great long-lasting theater or a great long-lasting business is the ability to find stability and longevity without becoming stale, to be strong in its foundations without ever losing its flexibility, to be rooted yet adventurous, prudent yet playful, wise yet curious, level-headed yet perpetually full of wonder. Always fresh, never dull, even within a settled framework or an established infrastructure, always finding something new. I think that this is also true of any great, long-lasting marriage. And so it seems very fitting tonight to sing this love song from our show, Long Story Short. Our investigative sources have revealed that this is also one of Kelly's favorites. Mr. Quattrone, I hope that you like it too. In this song, let's say after 40 years of marriage, a wife sings to her husband. It's called Still Love.
This is what we always wanted, to be side by side as we grow old, chatting each evening on the porch swing as we watch the days unfold. All of the lines and the wrinkles make a map of our lows and our highs. I love your crow's feet and your laugh lines and the deep brown of your eyes. The way I can nestle my head in your shoulder and it fits so perfectly. The way that your arms can encircle my waist when you're standing next to me. The way we fit better, shorter and fatter than we ever used to be. Every so often I notice your hair has a new strand of gray. Can't remember if I've told you, you still take my breath away. And if you don't hear so well, you can lean close when we're talking. Am I right? And if you don't walk so well, we can just sit here and kiss in the twilight. And if we don't remember so much anymore, we can dwell on the highlights. We don't have to be exciting. We don't have to run around. We don't have to dance the night away. We can be gentle, we can be still. You've always been gentle, and I always will love you. I still love you.
Thank you.
please welcome to the stage Vienna Ting. Vienna has graciously agreed to join us for some three-part harmonies on this this piece of special material. Raise your hand if you don't know what special material is. Until recently, I didn't either. But Kander and Ebb have a long history of writing special material for Liza Minnelli, for her first TV special, for her first comeback, for her second comeback, and for her third comeback. Brand new song for each of these shows. Well, basically what you do is you write a song that is only going to be sung on this one night. And that's the last it's ever going to be heard. We tried to make it as good as possible and yet wildly appropriate. So here comes something called The House That Kelly Built. One, a two, a one, two, a one, two, three, four. There was a man, he had a dream. He had a vision and a focus, like a blazing laser beam. Didn't aim for fortune, didn't aim for fame. He aimed to make great art on stage, and Robert Kelly was his name. He took some kids, they wrote some plays, turning flashlights into footlights, making basement cabarets. They worked all day, they worked all night, till every single line was landing, every costume fit just right. And the stage, it was just an old garage. Crew, they did their best to camouflage, and with plywood and with passion, they made drama where there used to be a car. In the house that Kelly built, the word spread far, the word spread wide. And then artists by the dozen came to work by Kelly's side. The critics raved, the tickets sold, the people flocked to see productions that were beautiful and bold. And the house, it began to grow and grow, and the man, he became a seasoned pro, more respected year by year. People came to each premiere from near and far, to the house that Kelly built. But it's not made of steel, ain't made from bricks or from I-beams, alright. It's built out of something more real. It's built from the labor and love of the folks here tonight. We all get good press. We got a theater works that is working, though we got no fixed address. We got some fortune, we got some fame, and we got to raise a glass for someone. Robert Kelly is his name. And the house, it isn't actually a place. All the magic happens in this rented space. But each brilliant new endeavor is in our hearts and minds forever, for the oldest established permanent floating theaters where we are. The house that Kelly built.
Well, the three words that I would choose to describe Theater Works are Kelly, Kelly, and Kelly, because it's his baby, it's his vision, and it's his inspiration. What Theater Works means to me is a really rare opportunity, because it takes its mission of diversity and of reflecting back society, of responding to the world by making art very, very seriously. I think one of the most unique things about Theater Works is that it combines a real sense of community with being a professional theater company. It has, for the 22 some odd years that I've known Theater Works, has not for one moment forgotten that it is part of Silicon Valley, that it is part of the peninsula, that it is owned by its subscribers. And so it really keeps a very close relationship with the community which it serves and which it leads. Congratulations, Kelly. Congratulations, Theater Works. Congratulations, Theater Works audiences. Thank you so much for 40 years of entertaining and enlightening us, for giving me the opportunity to be a samurai and a German cabaret singer and an Australian composer and most recently a Chinese American father. I am so grateful and I wish you 40 more.
Thank you, Francis, from across the miles, and thank you to Brendan, Valerie, and Vienna. Good evening. I'm Phil Santora, Managing Director here at Theater Works. As Gene alluded to in his speech, and I heard some gasps, I'm pleased to announce that Brendan, Val, and Gene will be in residence at the Lucy Stern for five days in December to do their hit Striking 12. So we expect to see you all out there. Tonight at Gala 40, we honor innovation. Innovation in the arts and innovation in technology. We have two honorees this evening. Both have a distinguished legacy of encouraging talent to flourish and grow. At tonight's concert, we honor TheaterWorks founder, Robert Kelly, who 40 years ago founded a company that would become an incubator for new musical theater. Earlier this evening, at a dinner hosted by our good friends and supporters, Microsoft, 300 of us honored a Silicon Valley technology legend with a gift to spot talent and promise in fledgling companies and the instinct to help them grow. Ladies and gentlemen, Frank Quattrone. Without Frank, we would not have the Silicon Valley we know today. The list of companies Frank has influenced includes, well, Amazon, Netscape, more than we can list tonight. It's only a 2.5 hour concert. However, as we celebrate people who nurture innovation, Frank Quattrone sets the standard for Silicon Valley. Tonight is a celebration. I'd like to take a moment to thank the tireless chairs for this evening's event, Michelle Quatnitz and Ronnie Watson, as well. I'd also like to thank the entire committee, the volunteers, staff, donors, supporters, everyone who made this unforgettable evening possible. You will find their names listed in your program. Please join me in giving them a round of applause. Breaking news, I actually had to write this into my script. All told, tonight's gala has raised over $450,000 for Theater Works. I want to thank you all so much for being a part of the Theater Works family and celebrating with us tonight. On with the show.
Over the past decade, Theater Works has forged a remarkable bond with one of America's finest composer lyricists. Beginning with the West Coast premiere of his Tony-nominated Broadway musical, Jane Eyre, Theater Works went on to premiere his next two musicals and make them unforgettable hits. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the creator of Daddy Long Legs and Emma, Mr. Paul Gordon. Starring two astonishing performers, Paul's 2008 adaptation of Jane Austen's Emma became Theater Works' best-selling show of all time and went on to productions across the country. Here tonight are Theater Works' own Mr. Knightley and his beloved Emma, Timothy Goulon and Leanne Marie Dobbs.
See how it feels?
Thank you.
Thank you.
We are so very thrilled to be here celebrating TheaterWorks, Kelly, and the amazing Paul Gordon. Tim and I have worked with Paul on several of his new musicals, and after continuing to be inspired by his work, we are so very proud to call him our true, dear friend.
Amen. This first piece is from Daddy Long Legs, which of course started right here and is now touring the country. In this number, a young Jerusha Abbott, who is a young college student, is writing to her unknown, unseen benefactor about meeting a handsome young man. Handsome young man. Thank you.
And
his affections start to, let's say, grow.
And like most men, he stubbornly refuses to admit that he's actually crazy about her. He reminds me of you in much younger days. Softly eccentric and set in his ways. He reminds me of you. It's funny, and yet, how can he really remind me of someone that I've never met? And P.S., I wish you and I could be friends. Wouldn't that be a lovely surprise? 'Cause P.S., how sweet to be writing to you if I knew the color of your eyes. We went for tea at an outdoor cafe. Oh, and his eyes were both blue, by the way. We talked and we talked. You should have been there. And then he went on about Milton and Whitman. I'm floating on air. And P.S. I blush when he offered his arm. And we walked under fair weather skies. But oh, boy, I wish that you'd been with us too. And I knew the color of your eyes. He made it seem like I'd known him from long ago. Laughed at my jokes, though they scarcely seemed apropos. I'll never forget, but really, the only man I've ever met. Then he took the train, and I heaved a sigh, and Julia got angry, cause he left without even saying goodbye, and P.S. is late. First musical here at TheaterWorks, Jane Eyre, I portrayed Helen Burns, a young girl who faces a serious illness, but has an unquenchable hope in the beautiful song, Forgiveness. You mustn't be revengeful. You have to be strong to offer good for evil. And return right for wrong. We must not hold a grudge, and we must learn to endure. Then, as God is our judge, at least our hearts will be pure. Forgive. forgiveness of those you hate will be your highest reward.
Paul's work is dominated by a wonderful sense of hope. And this next piece, it's the soaring finale to Jane Eyre. I play a blind hero, Mr. Rochester. Very handsome. Thank you.
So humble.
My mom's not even here. And Leanne will play the somewhat minor role of Jane.
The secrets of your heart are like the secrets of the house. They have finally been revealed.
There is no more to hide. I have looked death in the face, and though a part of me has died, I will never lose faith. I will never lose heart. For you have restored my trust. And I know you're afraid. I'm as scared as you are. Blindness and our pride,
and we'll never lose faith. We will never lose heart. For you have restored my trust, and I know you're afraid.
I'm as scared as you are, but willing to be brave, brave enough for love.
I will never.
Admittedly, my favorite piece of Paul's is this show. It's just very simply titled, Mr. Knightley.
Oh, my word.
Well, oh, you know what? Go ahead, Emma. Go ahead and sing it. Prove my point entirely. Anyone have a brandy?
Mr. Knightley. Mr. Knightley. Mr. Knightley. He is just my friend, a member of the family, always there whenever I'm in need. Dependable and fair, yet difficult and brooding. If there's something more I'm not convenient or preferable, practical, and it does not make sense. I cannot be in love. that would be too grim. I cannot imagine I could feel that way for him. No, it's too absurd. No one would believe it. He has been around me all my life. Why do I feel weak and suddenly distracted, longing to be bored by his critique? I cannot be in love. It's not what I intended or counted on or bargained for. That was not the plan. I cannot be in love. Something must be wrong. I cannot believe that I have loved him all along. Oh, but Harriet, why has my blood gone cold? I've seen him look at her. Why must this be so hard? It's only Mr. Knightley. Mr. Knightley. Oh, Mr. Knightley! Mr. Knightley? Mr. Knightley. Impossible and strange, yet obvious as daybreak, conclusive, indisputable and clear. My heart is now set free, and he must not pursue her when it's plain that he must marry me. Yes, I'm madly in love, and though it's not convenient, it's wonderful, it's torturous, and I think I may have hives. Yes, I'm sadly in love. There's no guarantee that there might be but half a chance that he's in love with. Anything can happen. He's in love with. Stranger things have happened.
Of course, only you, Emma, could end a song with the word me.
And only you, Knightley, could sing a song all about me and enjoy every single minute of it.
I know it's not improper for us to dance. It hardly is a scandal, space has no opinion. And though we are related by circumstance, you are not my sister, and I'm surely not your brother, though your brother and my sister have three children. It's confusing. Emma, I'm helpless in your grace. I see your kindred face when I close my eyes. Emma, the dawn breaks with your smile, and for just a while I am comforted. And if I never hold you, if I never touch you, if I never have the chance to quite express what I most hopeful of, then I never know love. You don't want me to marry, yet show no sign of anything but fondness for the friend you've known the longest. And yes, I'm slightly wary to cross that line. For what if it upset you? It would stain my pride forever. And I don't know what you'd say or how you'd act. Would it be foolish? heart wants what it wants, and it haunts me constantly when I'm with you, Emma. My soul lies at your feet. I have been discreet, but now I'm overdue. And if I never hold you, if I never touch you, if I never have the chance to quite express what I'm most hopeful of, then I will never know love, will never know joy, will never know what it's like to stroke your hair and feel your skin against my skin. But is this endless dance we're in, Emma, I've held this back too long. Tell me, is it wrong to be in love with you, Emma? The dawn breaks with your smile, and for just a while I am comforted. And if I never hold you, if I never touch you, if I never have the chance to quite express what I'm most hopeful of, then
now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome TheatreWorks Board Chair, Carrie Pickus, and Chair-elect, Mark Verschel.
Good evening. I do right now feel a little bit like the guy from the accounting firm during the Oscars.
I'm waiting for an envelope that someone's going to secretly give me.
Seriously, on behalf of the whole Board of Trustees, we're so thrilled to join with you in celebrating 40 years of TheatreWorks, a company that truly understands the importance of art and of creation of new art. Since 1970, we've put on our main stage 53 world premieres, and we've developed more than 110 new plays and musicals. Our works are seen in theaters across the country. We've become nationally known for our New Works initiative, and we've created an artistic home for, as you can see, some of America's greatest artistic talent.
As we look forward to our future, we recognize that the heart and soul of TheatreWorks is our deep commitment to nurturing playwrights, composers, and performers. We understand that a strong foundation is essential to empowering New Works, Main Stage, and our education programs.
So, to launch TheatreWorks into its fifth decade, we are introducing the Campaign for Art and Innovation. This $3.3 million campaign will help us invest in new world premieres and our New Works initiative. It will bring us into the 21st century with our technology, including better ticketing systems and a new website, and it will raise the profile of TheatreWorks both at home and nationally. Mark and I are very proud to announce that as of tonight, we have already raised over $1.3 million towards our goal.
These lead gifts have already had an extraordinary effect in our 40th season, the one we're doing right now and celebrating right now tonight. From our expanded New Works Festival from last summer, to the current success of To Kill a Mockingbird right now, TheatreWorks has grown its audience like never before. We've been able to care for and communicate to our patrons like never before. We produced two world premieres this year, two world premiered musicals, Tenured Hill and Daddy Long Legs, and five of this season's eight shows have already gone on to be on the top 10 list of shows most attended at TheaterWorks.
But we have so much more to accomplish. Looking forward to next season, we have three world premieres on the schedule, and our website is already in progress. When my role as the board chair ends in June and Mark takes over, I'll be taking on the lead of this campaign for art and innovation, along with a group of dedicated volunteers. We believe that TheaterWorks deserves to be recognized for its leadership, integrity, innovation, and artistic excellence. So tonight, I am asking you, inviting you, to join us in our campaign for art and innovation. Thank you so much. Here's the hard part, right? Here we go.
I gotta tell you, it's pretty extraordinary, the generosity of this incredible community and the depth of your support for TheaterWorks. So big kudos to you all, and thank you very much. At TheaterWorks' first New Works Festival, a fledgling rock musical received its first ever staged reading. Written by Joe DiPietro and David Bryan, keyboardist for the band Bon Jovi, it went on to a magnificent world premiere on this stage. Starring TheaterWorks' original lead actors, it then opened on Broadway on October 19th of this season. Yeah. The story of black and white America uniting in the music of rock and roll, it defines TheaterWorks' ongoing celebration of the human spirit. And here are Chris Critelli, star of this season's Tenured Hill, joined by Don Troop from our original production in the opening number of Memphis.
When I was a young boy, my daddy sat me down. He said, son, don't you never go to the dark side of town. I'm talking about downtown Memphis. You know that's where them black folk play. Well, I said, well, yes, sir, daddy. And then I snuck out anyway. See, never was taught to read none. No, never was taught to write. The only thing my daddy taught me was that a white should stay with white.
I heard it through the alleys, and it floated on a breeze. It burst out through the doorways, and it knocked me to my knees. It broke down all my senses, yet made me feel so.
I'm Joe DiPietro, and I'm here on Broadway with my and David Bryan's show, Memphis. And the way we got to Broadway was, see, a few seasons back, we got a call from this theater called TheaterWorks, and they were doing this New Works Festival, and they asked us if we had a show that we might be interested in putting in the festival, and we had the show called Memphis, but we hadn't really finished it, and no one had seen it before. We had no idea if it was any good or not, but TheaterWorks accepted, and some guy named Kelly said he would direct it, so David and I flew out, And we had a great experience there, and because of Kelly's great work on the show and TheaterWorks New Work Festival, here we are on Broadway. So thank you, TheaterWorks and Kelly, with all our heart. I wish we could be there for you today.
Hey, Kelly, I'd like to say to you and all of TheaterWorks, it is 40 years, I think. That's what my watch says. 40 years for y'all over there, so happy 40th to you and the organization and the theater and all that you do and have done and will continue to do. So, happy 40th.
Call me Big Daddy, the Big Daddy got bigger love. Watch this, mama, ow!
Hi, Kelly. Sorry I couldn't be there, but as you know, I'm here in New York on Broadway in Memphis. This show started at, of course, what I call my home theater, TheaterWorks. And I just want to say happy 40 years to you, Kelly, and to you, TheaterWorks, from popcorn all the way to Memphis now on Broadway. Kelly gave me the greatest note ever. We were doing Into the Woods, and I looked at him, and he looked at me, and he said, James. I said, yes. He said, be funny. Ever since then, I got a job, and I'm on Broadway. Doing what, Kelly? Being funny. You know I love you. Thank you. Have a wonderful 40th. Talk to you soon.
Last Tuesday, Memphis was nominated for 8 Tony Awards, including Best New Musical of the Year.
A honky-tonk bar, hear the wail of a blues guitar, have a beer, drop a dime in a blind man's jar. The blues sang softly in the air, just like a Sunday morning prayer. Just one more drink and you'll see God. Like a sad old melody, it tears you up but sets you free. That's how Memphis lives in me. There comes a time when
muddy waters run rough.
There comes a time when a man is
ready. Run away and say goodbye. Here I was born, and here is where I'll die. I'm just a man from Tennessee. I can't be what I can't be. All I know is Memphis lives in me. Had enough, like a friend who always stands by me. Memphis knows me, Memphis shows me how this life just has to be. Oh, I couldn't even try to run away and say goodbye. Here I was born. From Tennessee, I can't be what I can be.
In the world of musical theater, TheatreWorks is the gold standard for development. It's an incredible place for artists to come, to grow, to learn, and to get better.
Hi, I'm Andrew Lippa, and I'm sorry I couldn't be there this evening, but I wanted to do a little video tribute in my absence. I've taken part in the Writers Retreat several times and in the New Works Festival a couple times. And as a tribute, I'd like to be able to do something for Kelly in song. Get along, Robert Kelly, get along. You're the song, Robert Kelly, you're the song. Yee-haw! You are out west. Robert Kelly, you're not smelly, man, you're so swelly. That was a bad rhyme. But you see, at the New Works Festival, I'd be working on this song all the time, all the time. Nothing rhymes with Robert. Maybe you could say Hobbit. No, that's bad. Nothing rhymes with Robert. That's why we call him Kelly. Bobby. Yeah, you know this one. Bobby, baby, Bobby, booby. Nobody calls him Bobby either. Maybe we should start calling him Bobby. After 40 years, for God's sake, somebody call him Bobby. So in relative seriousness, I'd like to say congratulations to Kelly. Congratulations on 40 fantastic years. Congratulations to TheatreWorks. Love you, Bobby.
Last month, Andrew Lippa's The Addams Family opened on Broadway. They're the number one top-grossing new musical. They've already announced a national tour, and last Tuesday he was nominated for the Tony Award. But only 6 years ago, Andrew was premiering another hit musical right here, A Little Princess, with lyrics by Brian Crawley. The story of a young girl sent from Africa to a boarding school in London. It is now produced around the country. Its dormitory full of young kids define TheatreWorks' commitment to arts education and developing the theater artists of tomorrow. And for some of the young performers who hone their skills here at TheatreWorks, tomorrow has already come. Here are original Princess cast members, Sophie Oda, and Courtney Stokes, joined by Julian Hornick, the award-winning star of 2008's Caroline or Change, singing Live Out Loud.
Every day, sleepwalk, lockstep, no one dares to stray. Though they may, straight-laced, shame-faced, long to break away. I don't want to go along with the crowd. Don't want to live life under a cloud. Give me some air and space and the sun on my face. I want to live out loud.
Old and gray, sidewalks boxed in, thousands here to stay. If one day, side street, eyes meet, still they look away. They're as lonely as can be. Is that what they want from me?
I don't want to go along with the crowd. Don't want to live life under a cloud. Nobody wants me here, but I won't disappear. I want to live out loud.
I want to run down an open shoreline. I want to join in a moonlit dance. I want to swing from the branches of a tree. I want to bathe in a hidden inlet. Let the breeze come and dry my hair. I want the life they took away from me. If that makes me headstrong, fine. That's a fault. I'm glad it's mine.
I don't want to go along with the crowd. Don't want my sleeping broken and bad.
Why do I have
young, exuberant, and full of dreams. 40 years ago today, TheaterWorks began just like that.
Some say things happen by design, by demand, decree, or law. I say most things fall in line by the luck of the draw.
The song is from Janine Tesori's Violet. But the luck may be yours, you out there. Now, so get out your raffle tickets, break out your reading glasses, and welcome an actress and singer who has starred in many theater works, productions, new works readings, concerts, galas, and more. The effervescent Miss Molly Bell.
Kelly told me this is going to be a love scene.
A love affair, Molly, with the audience.
Oh, great.
Let's start this game right now. They've put enough in. This ain't bluffing. Let's see who wins.
Our first item is called Bay Area Theater Lovers. Woo, how many do I get?
Theater tickets, Molly.
Shoot.
Let's see. 339738. The winner is 339738.
Oh. Next we have Dance Like a Star.
Arthur Murray Dance Lessons 1 by number 338889. That's 338889.
And now,
the much anticipated 23 and Me DNA screening.
Ooh, can I go? I love screenings. Hollywood and the gorgeous dresses.
And the winner is...
And all those 23 guys.
And the winner is...
Screening the DNA.
And the winner is 339143. That's number 339143.
Yay!
Oh!
Wow, you got a lot of tickets there. You are bound to win something.
Next. 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 I'll tell you later.
Yes.
339143.
Okay. Ta-da!
Now, the next. Extreme sports adventure.
Extreme is my middle name.
Well, there's indoor skydiving, water slides, and...
Number?
339059. That's 339059. And now, my favorite item. The vintage wine collection.
I'm going to need the address of this winner. I like wine.
Number 037863.
Number 037863. Hey, 863, call me.
Some say things happen by design, by demand, to gain or loss. I'd say most things fall in line by the luck of the draw.
So those are the lucky guys, really lucky guys. Ryan Drummond, Noel Anthony, and Robert Brewer. And congratulations to all the winners. The winning numbers will be posted at the cashier's station in the lobby, and you can collect your prizes there. Now tonight we celebrate innovation throughout this thriving Silicon Valley. But where does innovation begin? Please welcome TheaterWorks' ebullient Director of New Works, Meredith McDonough.
Hello! New Works are the heartbeat of TheaterWorks. Tonight we've shared songs written from musicals that originated here, written by composers that have made TheaterWorks their artistic home. We're about what's new, and what's now, and what's next. And who's next? Last year, our New Works retreat featured the first musical written by a nationally known recording star, who then subsequently had a sold-out concert at last summer's New Work Festival. We've asked her here tonight to represent the emerging voices of musical theater. Please help me welcome the brilliant Vienna Tang.
It is such a pleasure to be here tonight, and such an honor. As Meredith mentioned, I first came to know TheaterWorks when I was invited to be part of the New Works Writers Retreat, and I'm very glad they invited me to do that because I had no idea what I was doing as a musical theater writer, and to be honest, I still don't, but I'm learning a great deal from this wonderful community. Sorry, that I've now become a part of. And so, in honor of TheaterWorks' humble beginnings, as well as living in the land of technology, as well as the experience of being at that New Works Writers Retreat and getting to hear other composers work through the walls, this is a song called One Bedroom, One Bath. Thank you.
bedroom on bath hardwood floors with view of trees, yeah. One bedroom on bath parking space for extra fee. A little flock of boxes and I surrounded by a painted white unknown. Soon as this wall in my heart comes down, I'm gonna make it feel like home. Gonna make it feel like home. Gonna make it feel like home. Make it feel, make it feel like home. Make it feel, make it feel, make it feel like home. Make it feel, make it feel, make it feel like home. Make it feel. Make it feel, make it feel, make it feel like home.
Make it feel like home. So, in a blatant attempt to link an existing song to tonight's themes. This machine I'm using is a looping machine. It basically records and then plays back in a continuous loop what's going on, but it also has a nice button called the reverse button. And I thought it would be interesting to play this song tonight because, of course, this is a night not only for looking back, but looking forward and to build on what the 40 years and the amazing history of theater works and where they can take it, where we can take it from here. And so this song features the piano played both forwards and backwards, and it's a song called Gravity.
Turning in revolution.
Thank you. I'm not a theater performer by any means. I am absolutely inspired by everyone who's been here on stage tonight. And of course, theater is all about storytelling, about bringing you into a different world and letting you live in that world for a moment. And being part of this community has really inspired me as a songwriter. And this is one song that I wrote after I came to know Theater Works and the whole Theater Works family, and I would like for you to help me perform it now. And it's a song called Grandmother Song. It's sung from the point of view of my paternal grandmother who, well, let me put it this way, a life in the arts is kind of inconceivable to her. And so I've decided to, maybe in a bit of an ironic twist, to put her into exactly that position and to sing her story to you. This is called Grandmother Song. If you could help me out by responding wherever you see fit and by helping me keep time like this. You think you got time, you're gonna get round to it way down the line. But a one step, two step, you fall behind it, so you better have a good plan. Oh girl, yeah, you think you got time, gonna get round to it way down the line. But I'm telling you, no matter what you have in mind, you're still gonna need a man. Take it from your grandmother, I've been round, I've been round, I've been round. Yeah, take it from your grandmother, I've been round, I've been round, I've been round. No, no one's gonna take care of you in that world that you got yourself into. All the good boys, honey, they're in grad school. Oh girl, yeah, your story's all wrong. Your dream will be a nightmare before too long. You're turning 30 and still trying to sing your songs. Oh, come on, who do you think you are? Oh, girl, it's too heavy a load. Your mama and your baba, they are worried souls. Oh, how you gonna raise a family when you're on the road with some tattooed boy with a guitar? Take it from your grandmother. I've been round, I've been round, I've been round. Yeah, take it from your grandmother. I've been round, I've been round, I've been round. No, this music career isn't real life. It won't see you through to when you're 65. And when the tide turns, you won't survive. Sit on the banks and cry. Cry, cry, cry. Baby's gonna cry, your baby's gonna cry. Oh, girl, yeah, you never know war when they come in the night and they knock on the door. And you can go from the high life to dirty poor and lose everything you knew. But the one thing they can't take away from you is your mind and the education you've been through. And so you find a man who understands that too. And make sure that he stays true, gives respect where it's due. Make sure he knows, make sure he knows, make sure he knows what he's got in you. Because a woman isn't just for cooking meals, scrubbing floors, making babies. A woman's got ambition, same as he does, maybe more. When the sirens wailed and the bombs fell, we ran from the schoolyard into hell. And when we could have been time, we'll never tell, because we never had your chances, the advantages that you have been handed. Oh, girl, you never know how hard it was. So you've got to do this for all of us. Take it from your grandmother. I've been round, I've been round, I've been round. Yeah, take it from your grandmother. I've been round, I've been round, I've been round. Yeah, take it from your grandmother. I've been round, I've been round, I've been round. Yeah, take it from your grandmother. I've been round.
Thank you. This has been an amazing evening, and I'm honored to be part of a chorus of artists across the land wishing Kelly and TheaterWorks a very happy 40th anniversary.
Hey Kelly, it's Jelko. You know, I think in some ways I still measure every new work experience against the good times I had at TheaterWorks. So congratulations to you and everybody at TheaterWorks on your first 40 years.
Happy anniversary to TheaterWorks.
Just wishing you and TheaterWorks the happiest 40th anniversary.
Congratulations, Kelly, on 40 years of wonderful achievement with TheaterWorks. And good luck with the next 40 years.
Happy anniversary, TheaterWorks.
Happy anniversary, TheaterWorks.
Happy anniversary, TheaterWorks.
The big 4-0.
Congratulations, Kelly, 40 years.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, Kelly.
That's Robert with a capital R and a capital K and a capital Silicon Valley.
Happy anniversary to TheaterWorks.
Hey, Kelly, happy anniversary. Happy anniversary to TheaterWorks.
Hey, Kelly.
Kelly.
Wow, man, you're a damn near legend. And you still have the ponytail. Sexy as ever.
You're awesome.
You're, oh, what was it?
Sexy as ever.
You, oh, it's Ken Nicholson walked into the room.
Couldn't be there, Kel, but wishing you the best for the 40th anniversary.
Here's to at least 40 more.
Wishing you another 40, Kelly. It's going to be great.
Happy anniversary to
keep working. Great work. Bye-bye.
Just what you usually do.
Thank God for Silicon Valley. I just became Vienna Tang's 3,032nd Facebook friend. But have you ever wondered why it's Silicon Valley but silicone implants? Anyway, writers worry about those things. Sometimes innovation is about inventions, sometimes it's about art, and sometimes it's about even more, about progress itself. The musical theater was once the domain of men, no more. In the course of the past decade, one immensely gifted woman has become the American theater's most acclaimed female composer. Jeanine Tesori has composed 4 Tony-nominated scores for Broadway, including Twelfth Night and the musicals Thoroughly Modern Millie, Shrek the Musical, and Caroline or Change. Caroline won both the Drama Desk and Olivier Awards for Best Musical, and its stunning TheaterWorks production won the Bay Area Theater Critics Circle Award for 2008. Before Broadway came Jeanine's beautiful country musical, Violet, which received its West Coast premiere at TheaterWorks in 1999. And a decade before that, a very young Jeanine Tesori wrote her very first musical, Galileo, and came to TheaterWorks to shape its West Coast premiere. TheaterWorks is proud to have been part of Jeanine's journey to the heights of Broadway and beyond. Ladies and gentlemen, Jeanine Tesori.
Well, we'll see and hear more from Jeanine later. But first, let's all share a song from her Broadway hit, Shrek, which begins rehearsals next week for its first national tour. Here are Noel Anthony, Molly Bell, and Robert Brewer, also known as Shrek, Fiona, and Donkey. And they'll be singing Who I'd Be with lyrics by David Lindsay Abaire.
I guess I'd be a hero with sword and armor clashing, looking semi-dashing, a shield within my grip. Or else I'd be a Viking and live a life of daring while smelling like a herring upon a Viking ship. I'd sail away, I'd see the world, I'd reach the farthest reaches, I'd feel the wind, I'd taste the salt and sea, and maybe storm some beaches. That's who I'd be, that's who I'd be. Or I could be a poet and write a different story, one that tells of glory and wipes away the lies. Into the skies I'd throw it, the stars would do the telling, the moon would help with spelling, and night would dot the eyes. I'd write a verse, recite a joke with wit and perfect timing. I feel this in my heart, confess the things I yearn, and do it all while rhyming. But we all learn, but we all learn. An ogre always hides, an ogre's fate is known. An ogre always stays in the dark and all alone. So yes, I'd be a hero, and if my wish were granted, life would be enchanted, or so the stories say. Of course I'd be a hero, and I would scale a tower to save a hothouse flower and carry her away. But standing guard would be a beast, I'd somehow overwhelm it. I'd get the girl, I'd take a breath, and I'd remove my helmet. We'd stand and stare, we'd speak of love, we'd feel the stars ascending. We'd share a kiss, I'd find my destiny, I'd have a hero's ending, a perfect happy ending. That's how it would be, a big, bright, beautiful world, but not for me.
An ogre always hides, an ogre's fate is known, an ogre always stays in the dark.
You're all alone.
All alone. And I
so yes, I'd be a hero, and if my wish were granted, I would be enchanted. would scale a tower to save a hothouse flower and carry her away.
Modern Millie, to lyrics by Dick Scanlon, an irrepressible flapper faces a dilemma that has plagued ingenues throughout theater history. The perfect match versus the imperfect dream. Which would you choose?
A simple life, nothing more. This. That either or, marry well, social world, businessman, clever girl, or pin my future on the boy I love. What kind of life am I dreaming? Gimme that thing called love. I want it. Gimme that thing called love. I need it. Highs and lows, tears and laughter. Gimme happy ever after. Gimme that thing called love. Gimme that thing called love. I crave it. Gimme that thing called love. I'll brave it, thick and thin, rich or poor time. Gimme years and I'll one more time. Gimme that thing called love. Gimme that thing called love. I'm free now. Gimme that thing called love. I see the flight of Sing Sparrow. Gimme Cupid's famous arrow. Gimme that love. I don't care if he's a nobody. In my heart, he'll be a somebody. Somebody to love me. I need it.
Set at the onset of the civil rights movement with books and lyric by Tony Kushner, Caroline or Change chronicles an African-American maid who finds everything crumbling around her, from her dead-end job to her High Hopes family. Now, one of the characters is unique in music theater. You see three women play collectively one character called the radio. They do so brilliantly, personifying Carolyn's hopes, fears, frustrations. From our award-winning Caroline or Change, here are Halili Knox, Dawn Troop, and Nicole Julian singing Salty Teardrops.
Disfigured woman journeys by bus from North Carolina to Oklahoma, hoping to be healed by a famous televangelist. Along the way, she sings one of the most beautiful lullabies ever written. Presented off-Broadway in 1997, Violet thrilled the theater world and won the New York Drama Critics Circle Award for Best Musical. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Jeanine Tesori.
Wow, I'm loud. All right. I would like to take a second to thank the musicians. Thank you. And Billy, who's done an amazing job. I mean, we sent him charts, and he's just been incredible. And I know he's backstage. You know, this evening has been filled with incredible music, as Patti Smith calls other people fellow workers, which I love, because she's a goddess and she doesn't need to say that, but she does. She always wants to know what people are doing. You know, people have sung really well tonight, and I'd like to stop that tradition right now. Okay? Because you're just getting old, and yeah. So I am not a singer-songwriter, I'm a songwriter. I write shows. I don't usually do this thing. You know, I can play, but I don't do this thing. There are very few people I will do this for. One is my mom, and one would be Kelly. Kelly, my mom. So, yeah. So look, there's gonna be cracking, there's gonna be out of tune stuff, it's just gonna go all over the map. And before I start, I just wanna say that I haven't been here since I think 1988, maybe 1989. It's changed, it looks really good. You've done some in the theater, I think New Jills or something. The The thing about the career, I don't know if you would call it that, what I do, but I think it's interesting that, you know, it's very easy to jump aboard when someone's already established, and it really takes someone, and I think this valley is filled with people who recognize what other people maybe haven't seen yet, and I think that's Kelly and Ev, it's both of them, but I think, you know, what Kelly does is he sees things before people see them, and that's what he did for me, and it was an incredible boost, and it gave me a lot of power, I guess empowerment, which is a really thrown around word, but it really did that for me, because it's not easy to be a mother and a woman, although I can wear a good heel, but it's not easy to do this. And when someone really, you know, gives you, backs you up with money and talent and says that they think that you have something before anybody else says it, it really means something. So I would just like to say thank you, I really owe you. And it's been my pleasure, so congratulations. So I'm just gonna croak this thing out. This is Laid on Your Head. I don't know if it's the best lullaby, it's a lullaby, and I'd like to dedicate this to Paul Gordon tonight. So much gentler than you see. Is there a chance you might redeem my days gone by? My days gone by. And oh, give yourself over.
far to the deep of days gone by, of days gone
For 40 years, TheatreWorks has been an artistic inspiration.
And for 40 years, one singular artist has guided that innovation. On behalf of the entire TheatreWorks family, I join you in celebrating TheatreWorks' founder, artistic director, and oldest living member, Robert Kelly.
Thanks, everyone. Thank you, Tony, for all these amazing years together. And thank you, David, for sharing your phenomenal plays with us and honoring us with your presence tonight. Thanks to our producers, Leslie Martinson, Meredith McDonough, and Bill Libertor in this red-hot band. A special thanks to my brilliant partner at TheatreWorks, Phil Santora, and to our fabulous staff, to Carrie Pickus, Mark Verschel, and all the fiercely dedicated members of TheatreWorks' Board of Directors, both past and present. You have let us fly, and I'm eternally grateful. I'm grateful, too, to tonight's amazing performers, technicians, and designers. You represent the thousands of extraordinary artists who have made these 40 years worth every minute. Seven astonishing composers have shaped this evening, and their inspired new works have elevated TheatreWorks to unimagined heights. It's been an honor, friends, to thank and honor you. Thank you. And finally, an endless adoring thanks to Ev, my partner in art, in life, and in love. Thank you. Forty years seems like a long time, but not to me. It's gone by in a flash, filled with a treasure of friendships and an astonishment of art. To me, it's been one immensely fulfilling collaboration, as full of miracles and mishaps today as ever before, but mostly miracles. But despite the wonderful things people have said tonight, this journey has never been about me, but about us. Never I, but we. We've made something wonderful here. Over 40 years, and 40 years is only a start. Thank you all for the journey called TheatreWorks.
Okay, Kelly, would you please take a seat? It's my great pleasure to contradict you a bit. I think, because it has been about you. You know, I was sitting backstage, anxiously waiting for each of my cues to go on, and I began to feel like I was in church at moments. And I recalled when I was a small boy with my brothers and sisters and mother in our old gospel church, and there was a song they would sing that we all loved to sing really loudly. It went something like this. Give me my flowers while I yet live, so that I may see the beauty that they bring. You know, I loved to sing that song when I was a kid, but I didn't really know really the depth of what it meant. And now that I'm older, I know how hard it is to really do that, especially for someone like Kelly, when you've known him as long as I have, or even a short time. You know, and there are not bouquets that are large enough. There aren't meadows of blooms vast enough, or even a single rose beautiful enough to give him what he deserves. But we are in theater, and we're addicted to trying to do the impossible. So, you know, Kelly ascended the mountain. He ascended the mountain, lights shone on the stage, and 40 years and 40 seasons, theater works. Now, theater works is, in truth, an outpicturing of this man's fertile, outrageous, and courageous consciousness. He's a captain among men and women, and he continues to say yes to the joy of the creative urge within him through the storms of economic uncertainty, through the doldrums of artistic stagnation, through the calamities of the times when body and spirit don't cooperate. And again, he miraculously navigates us to pitch-perfect waters of self-discovery. Now, this is love. This is Robert Kelly. Now, out of curiosity, I tried to calculate how many people had been affected by his work, how many audiences have sat in seats and been affected by something that Kelly was involved in the inception of? I counted millions and millions and millions, and that's growing throughout the country, and eventually it's going, you know, throughout the world. There'll be pieces that Kelly has touched. So, and every experience begins with Kelly sitting in solitude, expertly combing over each script, line by line, reading and listening to a score, imagining how the words and the music will celebrate the human spirit. And each fall, I began to think about this process that Kelly goes through. And through the holidays, he's reading scripts. And in January, and making those decisions. And he reads hundreds of scripts each year, and hundreds are rejected. Many worthy, but suited to flower in different climes. Now, for a few of those chosen, those fortunate chosen scripts, each season he spends countless hours selecting the perfect complement of directors and designers, supporting the selection of actors, supporting an administrative staff, and guiding us through a collective vision of excellence. And then the lights come up on stage, and perhaps a woman sitting in the audience, reeling in despair, the despair of a demeaning comment made at work earlier that day, suddenly catches herself laughing. Or a fought back tear escapes the eyes of an overwhelmed father and husband as he witnesses a moment of unexpected poignancy in the darkened theater, and he is given hope to bridge the chasm of emotional distance that threatens to destroy his family. Or perhaps we just sit in the seats to celebrate our lives, our families, and friends. You know, and I think of these moments as awakenings. Awakenings, awakening the heroic potential in all of us. And Kelly is the activator of all that. Now, 30 years ago, when I first came to TheaterWorks, Kelly doesn't know this, but I was a very interesting place in my life. I'd been devastated by a mentor who had disappointed and hurt me deeply, wounded me deeply. So I was looking for some way to engage in life, find who I was. I went to TheaterWorks, auditioned for Hamlet. Kelly pulled me aside. He didn't know me. I'd never met the man before. He says, good audition. I'm sure he's being kind. He suggested that I could get together with the star of the show. We could, for a couple of days, study the script, learn the scansion, understand what the text was, come back in a couple of days, and audition again. I don't know why he did that. He did. I came back. I was cast as Horatio. That was my first TheaterWorks production. Something began to shift in me. And over the years, again and again, Kelly's been instrumental in me finding my way to manhood. You see, I was a fatherless boy, trying to find ways to express myself, to express manhood, what that meant. And Kelly didn't know it, but he was helping me do that because just of who he is. Lessons like the first show I had a chance to direct here, Ain't Misbehavin'. And there came a moment when I was asked, forced, to make an apology for something that I was not responsible for. Kelly counseled me. He said, sometimes you have to take responsibility for things that are not your fault for the greater good. I resisted. I did it. The show went on. And several years later, that lesson came back up again. Had to deal with it again. But it was Kelly's voice teaching me, giving me lessons on how to be a man. Theater was a training ground for that. There was a production we did here of a show called Josephine. I made a bad choice as a director. And during the finale, the actors showed up in pink jumpsuits that weren't very flattering. They looked great on paper. I panicked. I went to Kelly. I said, Kelly, please, you have to do something about this. Kelly said, we have to go with it, Tony. It was a budgetary issue, among other things, but there was something else behind that. There was something I needed to learn about, again, about taking responsibility and maintaining a sense of grace, even when things weren't going well. And years, I saw Kelly do that over and over. There was always dignity in betrayal, in triumph. Kelly always exhibited dignity, grace. And during that production, Ev, his wonderful partner, came to me and said, Tony, I'll rent tuxedos for each of the cast members out of my pocket. And I had hope, oh, there's hope. Kelly said, no, we're going with it. Thank you, Kelly, for that. That was a hard lesson to learn. It was really tough. But I understand now. Because sometimes people in the position of leadership, of fathers, and that's what Kelly was to me in many ways, have to make tough decisions, have to stick to their guns, stick to the budget. Thank you, Kelly. And you know, Ev, I don't know if you know how joyful we were, the ripple of joy that went through the company when we discovered that you and Kelly were together. And we'd already learned to love you. But now that Kelly was going to be hooked up with someone who was wonderful, a life partner, we were so excited. And you've been, my God, what an incredible woman. I remember you singing in Pippin, Average Ordinary Woman. But there's nothing average or ordinary about you, baby. You're extraordinary in every way. And every challenge, every pain, every triumph that Kelly goes through, the company goes through, you're 100% there. You're his partner. We know it. And we're cheering for you, but we know you're cheering even harder. And it's just wonderful. It's glorious to see you too. You're an inspiration to all of us. I'm going to wrap up. I was thinking about this theme of captain and ships that's come up during tonight and journeys. And of course, I thought about Whitman's poem, My Captain. Of course, that poem was written for a fallen hero, for Lincoln. And it laments his death, but it also recognizes his saving of the nation, bringing the ship in home safely. But we're really fortunate tonight because Kelly's life is still in process. And we have him to share and to honor him tonight and tell him how we feel and show him. And what a blessing that is. And I'm so happy to be a part of this. In ancient text somewhere, it says that actors were the priests and priestesses of their time. Well, if that is so, I don't know if that's so. But if it is, Kelly is a god. And a god not to be worshiped, but to be thanked again and again in as many ways as we possibly can, and then again. So Kelly, thank you. Thank you for everything. And now, would all the cast members join me on stage and all of our honored guests? I believe this is the point. On behalf of everyone here at TheaterWorks, we wanted to give you a gift you could put to use. So we conspired with the production department and arranged for you to take a week off. Now, you'll have a house by the sea in Mendocino County, an indulgent dinner for you and Ev at St. Oars, and a gift certificate to pick out your new fishing rod. We hope you'll relax and enjoy it with all the love intended. And now, to wrap up the evening, we have a musical tribute beginning with this song from Brendan and Valerie.
How y'all doing? Anybody need to pee? I'm gonna take this next one about 210 beats per minute. Thank you. Yeah. This is from our soon-to-be finished musical Wheelhouse that we began here at TheaterWorks. This is called We Have Come This Far, and we're doing it because Ev said that it makes Kelly cry.
Well, we have come this far,
And look, we're still together. We haven't reached the stars, but for what it's worth, I like it on Earth
that we have come this far. For worse and now for better, we may have scrapes and scars, but all we've been through brings me closer to you.
Cause there is nobody I'd rather have at my side, facing heaven or hell. And this is the heart of the matter. My love is as strong as an old citadel, so let that be your home. It's built to last forever, wherever we may roam. When things look black, we'll bounce right back, no matter where we are. I know it's true, cause we have come this far.
The water is wide, I cannot get o'er, and neither have I wings to fly. Give me a boat that can carry two, and both
dawn, guided by the stars in your twinkling eyes. And we're here for the endurance, because you bring out greatness in all of us.
Give me a boat that can carry two, and bow the shower of my love and I. Another sunrise wakes me, before another night is gone. I'll find out where this highway takes me. You know I've got to travel on. Let my troubles all behind me, back there where I climbed on board. Jordan River's where you'll find me. It's wide but not too wide, too far. And as I'm going along, I carry with me promises that can't go wrong. As I travel on,
I travel on.
Janine Tesori.
I am on my way.
David Henry Huang.
I am on my way.
Robert Kelly.
Lord, if you want him. Lord, if you need him. Lord, won't you raise me up and on my way.
Oh dear.